Hi, this is Sophie. Welcome back to my channel. Butterflies are always highly requested, but today I'm going to show you a new twist on this famous design. The first thing you'll need to do is take some light blue on the tip of your sponge and use it to shape the top wing in a triangular shape. Make sure to keep it small because huge butterfly wings never look good on the face. The bottom wing is also a triangular shape, but this time pointing towards the ear. Tap gently with your sponge on the surface to make sure that no skin is showing through. Once you've done the other side, it should look something like this. Take now another sponge and load it with a darker shade of blue on the very tip and use it to apply this color only at the very edge of each wing in a straight line. Then reverse your half sponge towards the dry side and tap towards the area where both colors meet so that you blend them together. Repeat the same process on the bottom wing as well as on the other side of the face. I am now done with the sponge work, moving on to brushes, starting with a small round brush number 3 that I loaded generously with a dark matte purple. Starting at the very tip of the top wing, I am tracing a long curved teardrop all the way to the inner corner of the eye. If you need help painting teardrops, I have made another video explaining how to do it and I will link it in the description box below. Starting again at the top of the wing, paint a line shaped as a big hook along the side of the wing. For a pleasing effect, the line should start thick and end very pointy. If you'd like, you can also round the corners. Directly underneath, paint another slightly smaller hook. The next shape starts with a small line drawn towards the outside, followed by a curve going all the way to the outer corner of the eye. I then cover the non-painted area by thickening this line. Now this is optional, but if you'd like, you can add some eyeliner, making sure that you join both lines at the inner corner of the eye. And this is what it looks like at this point when both sides are done. If you want to slightly modify the shape of your wing, just stick your finger into a wet wipe and pull it along the side. The outline of the bottom wing starts with 2 teardrops, one longer one at the bottom and a shorter one at the top, followed by 3 hooks or U-shapes. And there again, you can round the corners if desired. After switching to a smaller number 1 round brush and still with the purple color, I'm going to do rows of smaller U-shapes on the inside of the wing. After finishing both sides, I double load a thicker round brush number 6 with white and blue. I explained in detail the double loading technique in a previous video that I will also link in the description box below. The first reverse teardrop is the longest, and to achieve this, you'll need to pull a thin line with the tip of your brush before dropping it down. There are 4 drops on each side, and as you can see, they're all facing in different directions and they have different sizes. So I recommend you practice on your hand or on your arm to get a good feel for the shapes before doing it on the face. If, like me, you notice that your small butterfly is not really symmetrical, just go ahead and double load your brush again and go over the drops that need to be modified. Time now to outline the small butterfly with the same dark purple color on a small round brush number 1, and I'm using the same technique as I used to outline the bigger wings. When both sides are done, let's not forget the body and the antennas of the small butterfly. Switching now to a round brush number 3 and a color white, I am going to paint a series of dots over the purple color. As you can see, I try to vary the size of my dots. Going from big to small is always, in my opinion, the most pleasing effect. Before you start with the dots, make sure that you work your paint consistency into something that resembles a thick cream. If your paint is too runny or too dry, you will have difficulties painting really nicely rounded dots and you will have to reload constantly. I then paint dots on the forehead on each side of the butterfly to create a pearl chain effect, there again going from big to small. Please give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed watching this video. Thank you and see you next time.